Hello, a very good evening to you. It's me, Scotty McClure. There you all are, and here am I. We're live on Facebook Live. 1 hour of superb scintillating information, education, and entertainment for all the nations globally around the world, live here on the world's top broadcast platform. That's Facebook Live. That is the big one. I'm Scotty McClure, and a very, very warm welcome. I'm Dinky Doo, and I am here for you. Get your comments in, I will read them out, and we will discuss them. Now, with so much to do and with so little time to do it in, so as quick as you possibly can, get your comments in there and we will start. Jim McIntyre's watching, Lynn Finlayson's watching, Alan Stitt is watching, Paul Francis Carroll, one of our finest musicians, is watching, Jerry Carty is watching. Ha-ha, says Paul Francis Carroll. Ha-ha to you, Paul Francis Carroll. Alan Stitt says, Dinky Doo, Scotty McClure. Thank you for tweeting to Bill Gates today and saying, help to fund Scotty McClure, Bill. That's excellent, Alan. Dinky Doo, Scotty McClure. Ian Walker says, Dinky Doo. Hello, Scotty. Happy Sunday night, says Ron Stewart. Roddy Martinez watching, a fine fellow. George Raffin's watching, a fine fellow. John Paul Preston, another fine fellow. Paul Gordon Cobain's watching. And Yusuf, Tayyip Yusuf is watching. No sound, he says. You should have sound. Richard Trenihady's watching. You're looking younger every day, Scotty, says Barry Wayne. Thanks, Barry. Ian Cook's watching up in Dundee, a very fine musician. Gaz Rowley Jones is watching. Good evening, my old friend. I hope all is well, says Carl Morris. Colin Edwards is watching, and Edward James. Pamela McAloon, hi Scotty, says Edward. Hiya Scotty, says Pamela. Can you say hello to my lovely niece Cara, please? And a wee kiss, hello Cara, and Dinky Doo from Scotty McClure and everyone else round the world, of course. Hi Scotty, says John Paul Preston. Darren Kelly, Pit Stop Kilmarnock, are you watching? Yes, indeed he will be, Ron Stewart. Got it now, thanks, says Tayyip, of course. And then we've got Richard Eyre. Isn't it interesting? When you can't get something, you think, no sound, somebody's responsible for it, not me. And of course, it's usually you. Hello, Scotty, I'm thoroughly disgusted with Westminster for dismissing Scotland at six, says Lynn Finlayson. I know, Lynn. I hoped I might be in line for doing the newscasting on Scotland at six. Hello, good evening, and welcome to Scotland at six. I'm Scotty McClure. Here's the news where you are. Dinky Doo. Angie Thompson's watching, so fantastic. Peter Ewing, I love it, says Peter. Fantastic, Peter. If anyone's asking, who is this guy that pops up on a Sunday night? It's Scotty McClure, the world's top broadcaster, just for you, Dinky Doo. I popped up earlier and did a promo, and I see that over 600 of you have seen the promo. That's fantastic. Everything with Scotty McClure on it, Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, LinkedIn, anything at all, just share it and share it and share it, because you and I are building a top program for world consumption, for global consumption. Very, very important. Right, Scotty, the Queen's train's costing 800,000 a year, taxpayers' money. She only uses it twice a year. Tell her to get the bus. No. I have no time for this empty politics of envy when it comes to the royal family. Get this into your heads, guys. I'm going to say this once and for all, and that's it. I'll probably repeat it a few times, of course. But the royal family cost us 52 pence a year each. They are an absolute bargain. They give the nation some prestige. They mean that there's not an absolute halt when you're getting unelected prime ministers. There's all that going on. They are not dictators. They are heads of state, the monarchs. They tried getting rid of the monarchy in this country. It was a disaster. Now, these costs are coming out different budgets. If you got rid of the monarchy, if you got rid of the royal train, they've already got rid of the royal yacht. I think that was a mad decision. I think they should build a new one as quickly as possible, because these are assets of this country. The Queen is the Queen of Scotland. She is our sovereign lady. And do not be distracted by the monarchy as a sideshow when you're talking about independence. The union of the crowns is nothing to do with the union of the parliaments. There was 104 years between the two things. So don't be making Her Majesty the Queen some sort of scapegoat for your politics of envy. Get the chip off your shoulder, see what's actually happening. Let's have more royal trains and more royal visits. Scotty, Deco asks you if you think Rangers, Servco or Dudesoon. I don't know. I don't comment on companies on here, Pam. Jamie Marshall, Scotty, you're specky. Something or other, says Jamie. I don't know what he's on about. Sounds cheek. The Queen's supposedly trying to break Prince Harry and his girlfriend up because she's a common as anything. I don't believe that for one moment. I don't actually believe it for one moment. We have had a number of commoners have joined the royal family, so there you are. Jamie Marshall, I don't know what he's on about. Yes, agree, Scotty. Bring more money to this country, says Heather Carr. Get rid of the royal kludgy as well, says Ian Walker. Ian, you should go to the kludgy. That's a nice idea. Vivian Scots is watching. One of our finest young singers, Dinky Doo. Vivian, loved your performance last week. Right, let's get rid of this Jimmy Marshall. He's obviously going to be cheeky. So there he is. That's him blocked. You'll never hear of him again. The council elections this year, you consider running for office. Councillor Scotty McClure has a ring to it, says Alan Stitt. Well, I feel the camel is a horse designed by committee, Alan. So I don't know how I would get on as a committee man, playing all these wee slippery games that councillors do with each other, trying to get the advantage. Scotty, what about Scotland getting its independence, says Pamela McLoone. Thank you so much, Scotty. You've made my night, says Vivian Scotson. Not at all, Vivian. You have made your wonderful life because you're an excellent singer. Good on you, says Pamela McLoone. Hello, Scotty, says Shug McDougall. Dinky doo to you, Shug. Lovely to hear from you. Tony Mac's watching. See, for a 90-year-old queen, I wonder what anti-aging cream she uses, because she's absolutely lovely looking for her age. Absolutely, Angie. I mean, McClure doesn't bother with makeup now. Perhaps just a wee bit blusher and stuff like that, you know, before we come on. But Scotty, I'd love you to be on Question Time, says Lynn Finlayson. I think I should be in Question Time. Question Time came from Glasgow last week, and nobody was actually getting stuck in properly. There was a wee bit of argy-bargy with John Swinney and David Mundell, but I actually tweeted, should the Secretary of State for Scotland, or the Scottish Secretary as they're called now, should they be representing Scotland's interests at Westminster or Westminster's interests in Scotland? That's the thing. And I think the Scottish Secretary should actually be a Scottish government appointment nowadays. Good evening, Scotty, says Joe Griffin. Daniel Blake just got a job, says Ian Walker. Thank you. Hello, Scotty, says Charlie Andrews. Hugh Miller's watching. Dinky doo to you, Hugh. Fantastic. 50 comments already, and we've just appeared. We'll have a share time. My clock's always a bit more accurate tonight, folks. I do apologize if there's been a bit of discrepancy, but I noticed the computer, which is supposed to be self-regulating, was a little bit out. The audience at Question Time are bust in from down south, said John Paul Preston. No, John Paul, not quite. Although I was a little bit disappointed. I thought Richard Dimbleby stopped Angus Robertson one night, or sort of intervened, I should say, when Angus Robertson was talking. He said, "Oh, don't start giving us that, or we'll be here all night." And I thought, no, we need a lot more respect. And I think the BBC could do with getting behind Scottish independence and saying, well, this is it. Or, you know, the BBC in Scotland becomes the Scottish Broadcasting Corporation. That sort of idea. Hi, Scotty. After a recent scary driving experience, I think speeding drivers are idiots and dangerous. Do you agree, Tony Mac? Of course, I agree. Although I fail to be impressed when I see the police jumping out when somebody's doing 38 or something and just surprising them, and other people get off with it. Hugh, it's Oxford ties, says Angie. Absolutely. Cheer up, Scotty, says Edward. No, listen, I'm very, very cheerful. I just wear, obviously, the weight of a number of years of experience, but I'm very cheerful, I'm very happy, so don't worry about that. If you see me looking as if I've got a wee bit of a down in the puss, I'm actually quite happy. Do you think the Lords will halt Brexit once they sober up, says Ian Walker? Well, the question I'm asking, should we go ahead with Brexit? I notice Tony Blair was wading in the other day, so there you are. And talking about it. Paisley Addy, I think he means Paisley Abbey, says Peter Ewan. Gordon Grimason, four eyes, he's saying. He's been cheeky, so what we'll do, we'll take Gordon and we'll block him. There we are, he's gone. Did your da, what's he saying is? Did your da sell even? No, he didn't. Scotty, do you think the BBC are biased? Says Lynn Finlayson. Well, I think during the referendum, I think it's very, very clear. I mean, I was sitting at my computer and I had the news at the 10 o'clock news on downstairs, and I could hear them, the editor at the time, the political editor at the time, saying that Alex Salmond had not answered a question when he'd answered it very, very fully. So that was bad news. There's Claire. We'll just say cheerio to Claire. Block Claire as well. Tony Blair's, no, he doesn't agree with Tony Blair, so that's right. Wonderful people, 25 of you have reacted already. You seem to have an angry head on tonight. Come on, cheer us all up, please, says Edward James. No, Edward, I'm absolutely 100% fine. Fatties should pay double on the bus, says Joe Griffin. Well, I had a new idea for the fatties. I think we should all do a fatty a favour. If you live next door to fatty, knock the door and ask if the fatty would like to come out for a walk. Take the fatty for a walk. I think that would be good. It's time for yes, says Peter Ewing. Yes. And Graham Irving on there for the people, he says. FTP for the people. Excellent, Graham. Jim Coyle is watching. Dinky doo, Jim Coyle. Lovely to have you on as well. Lol, fatties, I mind that call, says Angie Thompson. Absolutely. A very, very famous call, Angie. Forgive me, I'll tell you what it is. I might have a slight touch of the sniffles tonight, so I do apologise. I think that might be why, if you think I've got a lang face, I've got that wee nippy feeling behind the eyes. I walked to the kebab shop, says Robert Main. Yes, two seats, double the price, says Gareth Dunbar. Absolutely. A man called Dean says, do you think MPs should be allowed to use the bars in the Commons when they're supposed to be working? Well, I think the thing is, MPs work at all sorts of odd times, so they do need a degree of leisure. So there we are. Cheers, Scotty, says Jim. Fatties should not pay double. They should make bigger seats, says Hugh Miller, who's obviously Mr. Big. My missus is a fatty, says Dan McWilliams. Oh, you're going to catch it now. Have a wee dram, Scotty, says Ron Stewart. No, I'll have a wee sip of tea. Seize the day. Oh, that's lush. I think Tony Blair's done enough damage in this world, says Teresa McLaren. Your missus has been dusting and rising up the stew again, Scotty. Absolutely, Angie. That's what caused the sneezes. So if you put into Scotty McClue YouTube channel and you say sneezing, you will get what happened at the start of the program. What's your views on the idiot Donald Trump, Scotty? Well, I don't call him the idiot Donald Trump until we see what he's actually doing. There's a lot of bluff and double bluff going on in America at the moment, so we need to let things settle down. Giuseppe Bachetti and five others have shared the video. Fantastic. Yes, it's time for a share spot, I say. So let's share and share and share and share and share. Is there whiskey in your teacup, Scotty? Two king kebabs and a can of Diet Coke, says Shug McDougall. Yes, not so good for your sugar levels. Jim Stephen Gibbs watching Dinky Doo. I'm talking blood sugar here. Daniel Boyle, that's what Scotland needs, a Scottish Broadcasting Corporation. With you on at midnight for all of us night shifters. Absolutely, I thought I'd probably run it. I was tipped to run it, you know, if we'd had independence. Exactly, Scotty, says Heather Carr. So there you are. Over 100 comments, guys. Over 100,000 people have seen the Scotty McClue live Facebook live videos on a Sunday night saying Dinky Doo just for you. Here we are. Shared, mate, shared. Do you think Scotland will have its own navy so they can catch the Saltcoats pirates? Shared, mate. Says Ron Stewart. Excellent, Ron. Sandy Holland and six others have shared the video. Let them know you appreciate it. We appreciate it very, very much. Martin Monaghan's watching. Dinky do to you, Martin. Lovely to hear from you. I'm just putting off another device here. There we are, so it doesn't interfere. Do you still have a copy of the Megamix, Scotty? If so, can we play out to it? Jonathan, yes, but I don't want to put music on because I think you're then into the copyright things, which is different from the point of view of the radio stations. They've sorted all that. Janice says, Peter Ewing, so something going on there, guys. Yes, if we had our independence, would Scotland have its own army, navy and air force? What I would do if I was the first minister, I would probably move my office into the castle and I would keep the Royal Regiment of Scotland and also make sure it was renamed as the Argylls, the Camerons, the Seaforths, the Royal Scots Fusiliers, Royal Highland Fusiliers, I should say, and things like that. And we've got it all here. Robert Bain says, why are there women on here? They should be doing their motherly duties and tucking the kids in. The first rule of a fat club is cake, says Joe Griffin. Barry Wayne, all 100,000 of us crowdfunded you for a tenner. You'd become an instant millionaire. Well, I would use the money to build up the programme, Barry, but there is a GoFundMe page. So if 100,000 of you want to stick in even a quid, that will get us started. GoFundMe, and then www.gofundme.com/Scotty-McClue. You'll see the link on the Facebook there. The pest control man's favourite song, there's a moose loose about the shoes. Second rule is cake. John Douglas says, evening, Scotty. I, Robert Bean, the dishes aren't they going to do themselves, says Joe Griffin. So there you are. Somebody's getting a bit of a row there, I suspect, folks. Right. First share point of the evening. Share, 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 share. All right. Have you shared it? That's excellent. So there we are. And if you watched the promo today, you would know that we're talking tonight about news and saying, should it be about world leaders or would we be better having it about us? What's the first rule of a junkie? If a fatty is cake, first rule of a junkie is get yourself clean. So there you go. I, Robert Bean, the dishes on it, didn't say we've done that. Margaret Bonner says, shared, good, share. Come on, folks. Sharing, 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 sharing. Everything that you can see on Facebook with Scotty McClue on it, share it with all your pals. Also, write a little note on your Facebook. Type in, are you all watching Scotty McClue? And take the link off the top of the page. Right-click it and paste it and send it round, guys. Because if you send it round, everyone, we'll get everyone on. Fatties need to share that. Lord Lucan, has he got a GoFundMe page? No, 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 Lord Lucan's away. SNP pre-Indy 2014 wanted to keep fast lane but non-nuclear. This would be the base for the Scottish MOD, including a military airbase. Well, it's well set up for it, of course. Good communications. Scotty, are you any use at ironing, says Heather Carr. Of course, Heather. Excellent at ironing, although the bonnet's got a wee crease in it, you might see. Bob the Blanket's watching in Blackburn in Lancashire. Hey, dinky-doo, Bob lad. Hey, love to Blackburn, I say. Beams, not bombs, says Lynn Finlayson. You're quite right, Lynn. The children come first. We don't need the bombs. It amazes me that people are objecting to refugees coming to this country. Perhaps if their own country hadn't been carpet bombed by various superpowers, they might not be having such a tough time and they might want to stay at home. So there you are. We need more farming in Scotland. We need to start growing more of our own resources before this Brexit hits hard. It's Brexit, John Paul. But, of course, you take, for instance, what I call the larder of Scotland, Murrayshire, and places like that, and Invernessshire, and Aberdeenshire. Is that the same bonnet you've always had, says Robert Bain? No, I have a variety of bonnets, Robert. This one we bought in Ilkley, Ilkley Moor Bat Hat, which just means on Ilkley Moor without your hat. On Ilkley Moor Bat Hat. On Ilkley Moor Bat Hat. There we are. And we've got the wonderful Vicky Navarro watching. Dinky-doo. Give that big man of yours a hug, Vicky Navarro, you lovely lady. The Mexicans are going to build a ladder, Captain, says George Ruffin. Well, I've not got much time for waltz. Come and do mine, and I'll fund you more, lololol, says Heather Carr. Thank you, Heather. You're not talking to me, Scotty, Margaret Bonner says. Margaret, I've already mentioned you two times, so I don't understand. Maybe you're missing it. Scotty, do you think if every school banned history, maybe we could start again from scratch? No. I am something of a historian myself, and I think if you know your history, and you need to know lots of it, because there's a lot of what I would call historical revisionists. Winston Churchill was one of them. He wrote the history of the Second World War, and I've always wanted a copy of The Fool's Set, and my cousin supplied them. My late uncle had them, and my cousin supplied them. Marvellous, I've got The Fool's Set. But he was something of a historical revisionist, old Winnie. Scotty, if the ball was in the other foot, would other countries take us in? This is it. This country's full enough, says Stephen Burrows. Depends where you're from, Stephen Burrows. Come to Scotland. I was watching a programme last night, and Scotland's depopulated. There's an island with no population on it. And it was cleared, of course. It had 300 people in three villages. Margaret's very needy. Vicky Navarra has sent me three beautiful kisses. She is such a princess. Give that man three kisses back, Vicky Navarro, and a big hug for you, my dear. I agree, Scotty. They run them from their homes now. They're crying wolf. I live next to Polish and Congolians and Romanians people, and they're nice. They never pass without saying hello, says Angie Thomas. Of course, people are people, Angie. There's only one race, so we shouldn't have races. There's only the human race, and we're all members of the human race. Great show, says Drew Steed, dinky do. Says Ron Stewart. Great show, Drew Steed. Women with opinions. Ha ha, what a world, says Joe Griffin. So there we go. No, if you think about it, you had the Highland clearances. Now, could you imagine if we bought London, if all the wealthy people in Scotland GoFunded Scotty McClure, then we bought London, and then we said to everyone in London, listen, we're going to clear this space and put sheep on it because we feel that's more economical. Would that go down well, I ask you? Only saying. Nottingham is full, says Steve Burrows. Okay, Nottingham's full, but Scotland's depopulated. I can't drive round the corner without getting stopped in a traffic jam, says Edward James. Where are you, Edward James? The old Congolians are all right, says Robert Bain. 1841, says Edward James. What happened? In 1841, Queen Victoria had been 4 years on the throne. Palmerston sent a gunboat in 1841. I remember that. The Don Pacifico incident, a Portuguese Jew living in Athens, and living in Gibraltar from Athens. Scotty, hello from Orkney. Let me see, I just missed that. Let me get back, please. There we are, 1841. Scotty, hello from Orkney. We need young families in Scotland. We should welcome those who choose to come and live here, says Fiona Mora Graham, up in Orkney. She's up there as an Arcadian. Are you an Arcadian, Fiona Mora? I would suspect you may well be. Share. What time we got? Yes, coming up to share point. Campbell's, says Edward James. What about them, Edward? A very, very powerful clan. Pardon me, I'm just going to give my hooter a wee blow. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. Ah, that's it. A wee bit bunged up at the moment in the hooter. So I do apologise if my voice isn't up to its normal high standard. Share, says Melissa McAleer. So there we are. Scotty, yes, I definitely agree with putting sheep in London. I remember when I was a shepherd. And I found when I lived in London, I was unemployed a lot of the time. It was very strange, just difficult to get the work. If I bought London, I'd ask for a refund, says Joe Griffin. Well, of course, London is not the most ideal place. It's on a mud flat. Did you know that? London's actually on a mud flat. Very well said, Scotty, about migrants. My wee granny was an English migrant who lived in Glasgow from aged 18 and was the most Scottish out of all of us. Imagine all the fine English people who will come, says Martin Monaghan. See more. Martin's got some more. I'll try and see more, Martin. It's not always easy on this because it's very, very small. So there we are. Most Scottish. We become fine English people who will come to Scotland after we become independent. Absolutely. I think the one of the first things we need to do, remember, Scotland was depopulated through social injustice, right? Throwing the people off the land. So we need to repopulate it through social justice. And then that rights a wrong. That happened to my great-great-great-granny cleared from her home during the Highland Clearances, says Vivian Scottson. There you are, the Cheevy at the Stag and the Black Black Oil. So there's lots and lots to look at. I do beg your pardon, folks. Sorry about that. Dinky-doo, laddie, says Sean Finlay. Michael Yule's watching. Good evening from Anglesey in North Wales, says William Scotty Love. Fantastic. Anglesey, I know it. A fine part of the world, yes. Yes, Scotty, says Heather Carr. I defo agree with putting sheep in London. Can you tell Mrs. Mac Rosie how much I love her for getting me into radio and the media? I'm really proud of her strength and courage with losing her parents. A strong lady and a proud daughter to her. La, says Tony Mac. See more. We'll see if we can see more, Tony. Very tricky. There we are. Strong lady and proud daughter to her late parents, says Tony Mac. Absolutely, Tony Mac. A lovely, lovely thing to say. Scott Acab Howell, he says, have you ever been in Bigger? Yes, I've been in Bigger lots and lots of times, because I used to live in Edinburgh, and I'd be travelling south a lot, and I would take the road through Bigger. Enough sheep in Westminster, says Hugh Miller. Give a man a fish and he'll eat for a day. Give him a rod and he'll always eat. Give an Aberdonian a sheep. Yes, excellent stuff. Marvellous. People want their own country. They don't want to be here. Our government ran them out. Treat yourself with a nice bit of steam pudding. That'll cure your sniffles, says Joe Griffin. Quite right, Joe. Good man. Now, if you've just joined us, you're wondering what on earth's going on. You're watching Scotty McClue, and we are, of course, live on Facebook Live, the world's top broadcasting platform. This is the world's top broadcaster talking to you globally. So let us know where you're watching. Get the vapor rub on your feet at bedtime with socks on, of course, and get these sinuses clear, says Angie. Treat yourself with a wee bit of steam pudding. We've got that one. I think once we're independent, a lot of Americans, Canadians and Australians will emigrate here. Well, the only thing, John Paul Preston, we don't really have the weather here, but we do have the seasons. And I remember talking to a very famous old Italian gentleman, and I said to him, we were in the garden of his country house, and I said to him, what do you think of the weather we get here, Jack? And he said, wonderful. We crave a little bit of sunshine, he said. But Colin, I'll take you to Italy, and I shall show you old men bunned up with the sun. So there you are. Excellent stuff. That's what he called me. It's about time to ban the burqa. If I go into a shop, I'd have to take my crash helmet off. What's the difference, says Steve Burrows? Well, there is a point there. The only thing is your crash helmet does not really have a religious significance. So we do need to talk about that. So there we are. That's where people get the wrong, Angie. They put it on the soles of their feet, not the chest. He's spelt soles, S-O-U-L-S, S-O-L-E-S for soles. Grant Elder GG is watching. Dinky do to you. Evening, Scotty, says Esther Hart. Two beautiful kisses. Love finding a bit of chocolate at the bottom corner of my handbag. Minstrels rarely melt or gather dust from the bag. A half-eaten Turkish delight is a different matter. Absolutely, there might be a wee bit oos on it. Scotty, what's the best country you've ever went to? Mine's was Puerto Plata, Dominican Republic. That puts things into perspective when you see kids and families with nothing. Absolutely. Good evening, Scotty, says Louis Faber. Absolutely. Excuse me a wee second. I'm a wee bit munged up with the cold tonight, so you'll just have to bear with me, folks. That's the stuff. There we are. You will just have to go along with that, I'm afraid. You know, Scotty, sorry I'm late. I've been a busy, busy, busy. Lol, what's the subjects tonight, says Francis King. Francis, our main subject tonight is news. Now, there's a lot of talk about fake news around, And Donald Trump is attacking the American media. But what I'm actually saying is, well, he's attacking the media. But what I'm actually saying is, should the news be about all these world leaders, or should they just be an "and finally" at the end? So rather saying, "Good evening, here is the news. Donald Trump," they should say, "Good evening, here is the news. Willie McWackle has lammed 200 yows." You know, and stuff like that, you know, just something, and finish. And finally, in America, Donald Trump, who's the president, has said blah, blah, blah. And make it about the people. Make it about us, about you, and about me. I'm slowing down a bit on there. I can see myself slowing down. A bit of lip sync problems. "Good evening, Scotty," says Louis Faber in London. "Dinky doo, Louis Faber. Lovely to have you with us. Good evening, Scotty. Sorry I'm late. I've been busy. What are the subjects tonight, Sir Francis?" Well, I did say that to you. The subjects, Francis, as I say, are the news. Lucas Kits da Silva. "Hey, can you send a message to Brazil? Thanks." Of course I can, Lucas. Brazil will be watching right now. Not a problem. "Just logged in. Do we have a topic tonight, Scotty? Does the audience give money to Glasgow beggars?" Well, it depends. I gave a musician some money one time, and somebody says, "Why did you do that there?" And I said, "Because he's only one paycheck away from me." So there you go. It's worth a thought, isn't it? Sean Finlay likes the fact that Andrew Love is watching. "Scotty, tea or coffee?" says Edward James. "Tea. Haven't had coffee for 36 years." There we are. Lynn Finderson, "Scotty, visit Coyers Cafe in Duke Street and you'll get a hot toddy," says Lynn Finderson. So there we go. Hot chocolate would sort me. "Have you ever climbed Ben Nevis?" says Andy Mackay. "No, but I was in Fort William with my mother not long before she passed away. And I remember she was with my aunt down at the shops, and I took the dog a good old bit up the Ben for a walk." Fantastic. But I haven't climbed Ben Nevis. I've climbed the Cobbler, although I didn't actually go out to the wee standy out bit because the wind was pretty powerful. I didn't want to get blown off the Cobbler. But I've also climbed Blencathra, Saddleback in the lakes, things like that. "Hi, Scotty. My cousin in the Kikaboo Islands near Australia is receiving you loud and clear," says Ian. Is that not fantastic? Dinky doo to Ian Walker's cousin in the Kikaboo Islands near Australia. I say hello and welcome to Scotty McClure's Global Programme, the best hour you will spend in the week. Scotty, the worst 10 tourist destinations was published. Keep this going here, folks. Wendy MacDonald Thompson, "Can you give a shout out for the clothes collection for Homeless Scotland? Saturday, February the 25th at George Square, 12 o'clock." Thanks, Scotty. So, Wendy MacDonald Thompson, George Square, 12 o'clock, clothing collection for Homeless Scotland, folks. And thanks very much, she says. But listen, thank you, Wendy MacDonald Thompson, and all your friends for everything you're doing for the homeless people. It's absurd that we have this in Scotland, and it's something that would need to be sorted immediately. That's why we're wanting independence, because when grandees down south have been feeding all their pals in the banks and bailing them out, people really, really, really suffered under this so-called austerity. I was down in London visiting, and there was no austerity down there, I can tell you that. "Scotland, I was saying to my missus, Manfrey's worse than giving birth. Triplets even," says Ian. Is that right, Ian? I didn't realise you'd had triplets, but well done to you. And you'll know more about that than me. Hot lemon drink and hot water bottle. So there you are. For your old toesies, Edward James. When I used to stay with my grandfather in Argyll, he put what was called a pig in your bed, and the pig was a stone jar. It was two light brown and dark brown clay bottle, and you could only just touch it with your feet. Roasting hot. CNN, Clinton News Next, what no longer have any influence, says Martin Monaghan. Well, CNN, you see, what you've got to do is watch all these media companies. The lovely thing about Scotty McClure, I have no agenda. So you'll always get the truth from me. You'll get the facts. "And finally, is never out of the news," says Barry Wayne. Excellent. Sean Finlay, Unless the news concerns us, we really shouldn't give a shiny. Dinky doo, Scotty, says Andy McCloudy. 50 people have reacted. How fantastic. Dinky doo to all of you. Is it time for a share? I say, I think so. Let's have a share point, everybody. Share, 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 share. Ah, fake news. The man is box office gold, building safe compounds in Syria now to stop mass immigration. Great idea. No more foreign aid. Keep it for the OAP, says Grant Elder Gigi. I know, Grant, but if you've been carpet bombed out your house, you're going to want somewhere to stay. So there we are. Scotty, the worst 10 tourist destinations was published. Must be a tie because Posso was mentioned. Posso Park's lovely. I went for a week there for holiday. Beach was beautiful. Sometimes the good points in politics is going on, etc., around the world. I'm more interested in this guy from Korea who is it can John some or summit. See if his stepbrother. So there you are. Yes, something like that. David Jimison's watching. The wee standout bit is called the Eye of the Needle in the Cobbler Grant. Is that right? The Eye of the Needle up in the Cobbler. Well, you know what they say, it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. So my wee standy outbits as Grant Elder Gigi is something different. Any news about going more than once a week, Scotty, says Steve Burrows. Well, the only thing, Steve, there's going to be meetings this week at a very, very high level. So we'll see what McClue's going to be doing. Excellent stuff. If you want to put some pennies in to GoFundMe, folks, please go and do that. You'll see the link on Facebook there. And remember, there's zero embarrassment as far as I'm concerned about GoFundMe. A lot of you have been saying, oh, well, I'm not putting anything into that. And some of you maybe can't afford to. Go on to GoFundMe and share it. We're perfectly open about it. There's 255 quid has arrived. We're looking for 5 million. So we're on the right track, we're heading the right way. So what I would suggest to you is go to GoFundMe and share it so that everybody gets a look at it. And if you can stick something into it, wonderful. Toto Franchitti is watching. Toto Franchitti, lovely to hear from you. Scotty, do you think heading a football gives you dementia? Scotland's crap at football, and so we should be dementia-free, says Ian Walker. There we go. Terrible thing, dementia, Ian, I can tell you that. Have you been up Tinto, says Scott Acab Howe. That's a very personal question, right? But I do know Tinto, actually. A wonderful part of the world. Now then, not heard anyone Skype in a few weeks. Do you still take the Skype calls, says Francis King? No, I've stopped the Skype. The reason you haven't heard anybody Skype me is because the Skype is switched off. So that's what's been going there. Excellent stuff. A China pig, Scotty. We used to sing a song. Jump into bed with your wee China pig. That's right, Angie. Your wee China pig. Was that the same one that the Alexander brothers used to do? I'm sure there was a wee China pig they sang about. We shouldn't all be told the truth about what's going on. Our world would not be hit of lies. Wait a minute. Hang on. We'll see what's going on. This is Teresa McLaren. We shouldn't all be told the truth about what's going on, or our world would not be hit with lies. Don't entertain the news on our channels. I watch RT. RT, I take it, is Russia Today. Привет, привет. До свидания. John Paul Preston and 13 others have shared the video. Fantastic. Share, 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 share. I need to watch RT for the Glasgow news, says Ian Walker. Did you not have a dog called Reef or Ref, says Liam Thompson. I had a dog called Reith after Lord Reith from Glasgow, who started the BBC. R-E-I-T-H. Google him, John Reith. He started in 1922, the British Broadcasting Company, as it was then, not the corporation. And he had four, there were four employees, I should say, himself and three others. He was the general manager. And you had an engineer, you had a secretary and a program controller. And that was the start of the BBC. Now, I think the BBC employs around 27,000 people. I first applied for the BBC in 1975, and I've had little bits of work from the BBC since, but I thought I would be excellent for the BBC as a national radio host at nights, something like that, or during the day. I should actually have taken over the Jimmy Young programme when Jimmy finished with that one. That would have been good. So there we are. I think Scotty McClure in the morning on Radio 2 would have been superb. So there you are. Yes, I had a dog called Reef, and I've got one called Clyde now. Reef died after 13 years. He's waiting for me at Rainbow Bridge. We took him to the beach at Ayr on his 13th birthday, but he was getting a wee bit done. Richard Mackay is watching. Dinky doo to you, Richard. James Michael Harvey and 14 others have just shared. We thank you. If we didn't bail the banks out, the vaults would be empty, creating a safe, warm, and dry place for the homeless to sleep. There we are. I don't know that I would want to be locked into a bank vault, mind you, to be quite honest with you. But it would be certainly warm and dry. Keith Hodgson's watching. Hello, Keith. Dinky doo to you from me, Scotty McClue. Lovely to have you with us. What do you think of what's happening in Gambia, Scotty? Do you think they will have peace now? I would love to see peace throughout Africa. You see, they talk about Africa being a poor country. Africa is a very, very wealthy country. But if Africa gets developed, what happens to poor old Europe? The tumbleweed goes down the main street. The devil's beef tub, says Edward James. Are we talking? Where is the devil's beef tub? I have heard of it, of course. I know the devil's elbow on the road coming down to Blair Gowrie from the north. I think it's sort of ironed out a bit, the devil's elbow, but the devil's beef tub. Where's that? Do you think Sydney Devine should go on The Voice? Yes, I'm a huge fan of Sydney Devine. You'll hear me interviewing Sydney Devine on BBC Radio Scotland. I think it's on YouTube. PMSL, Scotty, well done at that diplomatic avoidance, says Grant Elder GG. Not at all, Grant, no problem at all. I am something of a diplomat. I think I would make a fabulous creative and cultural ambassador to the United Kingdom. 5 million, says Carol McNamara. What's she talking about? 5 million. Yes, 5 million, Carol. What we can do, we can then look at purchasing media assets and set them up and have an independent Scottish media. So you can see where I'm coming from. It's all there. 5 million is very small in commercial terms, but it would get us started. And we're already £255 up. She's talking about the GoFundMe page. So there you are. We're looking for £5 million. That's the eventual target. Now, it might take a wee while, but if you think about it, if everybody in Scotland gave a quid, then we'd reach our target tonight. Louis Faber, have you spent any of the money on GoFundMe? Can you please be transparent with your viewers? Of course, Louis. Always transparent. That's the whole point to it. No, we haven't spent a bean yet. It's sitting tucked in there. And then we'll purchase some equipment. But we want to get that moving and get it up a bit. Is the cobbler at Helensburgh, says Edward James. Well, the cobbler is, I would have said you would go round to Araker. And you go through Araker. Is that right? Round the corner, and then there's a little place you can park. And then you walk up the path, and then you scramble the last few bits up to the cobbler. But it's not for the faint-hearted. And you can see the old cobbler bending over the last. So they are fantastic. I call my triplets Mary, Mungo, and Mitch. Fantastic. God loves a trier. 5 million, says Carol McNamara. Carol, you have to put this into perspective. It's not a question of loving a trier. £5 million is very, very small in commercial terms. So there you are. I mean, radio stations, I'll give you the whole of the Guardian media lot went for about 70 million. So there you are. Scott FM sold for about 5, 6 million the first time, and eventually for about 27 million or 25 million when Guardian Media bought it. So that's just, I'm just putting things in perspective for you here. So 5 million is tiny if you're going to buy media assets with it. Why has the Skype been switched off? Says Richard Mackay. Well, we had a couple of wee swearers, Richard. Now, I know they shouldn't spoil it for everyone, but we lost all the video from one of the programs because one of them had effed and jeffed on air. So until we can purchase through the GoFundMe account, a profanity device, an on-air profanity device, which will give us a delay. We're not opening up the Skype mode. Plus, it had mixed feelings. Everyone said, "Oh, get the Skype open. It's lovely to hear the callers." And somebody else said, "No, don't have the Skype, Scotty. It's spoiling the whole program." So there's a lot of argy-bargy. So we need to discuss this because this is not my show. This is your show. This show belongs to the people of the globe. It belongs to everyone who's on Facebook. Good night, Scotty and Dinky Doo. This is Lynn Finlayson. Dinky Doo to you, Lynn. Are you away? Share time, folks. Quarter to 11. Share, 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 share. But if Lynn's off to our bobos, good night to you, darling. Mwah. Have a lovely, lovely evening. So, Carol McNamara, get thinking and get funding. Get your thinking cap on. You're obviously a clever lady. And, get going there. God loves a trier. I mean, do people say that to all the other media moguls that go, well, I'll tell you this, Sir John Reith. You think that the BBC will employ 27,000 people? You think the BBC will raise £320 million a year from Scotland? God loves a trier. But, newsflash, that's the case. So there you go. £1 each and the 5 million's in the bank, says Martin Monaghan. Absolutely, if everybody puts in a quid, it's done. Aye, that's it, says Angie Thompson. So marvellous stuff. So there you have. You've got to explain these things to non-business people, you see. Do you ever visit Ayrshire, Scotty? Yes, I often visit Ayrshire. Depends what bit. I quite often visit Ayrshire. It's a lovely, lovely part of the world. Moscow, do you know Moscow? So there you go. My favourite country is Ireland. Had a great honeymoon. The Irish are wonderful and beautiful people. Very like the Scots, but they've kept a lot of their wonderful manners, especially if you're right down the south to the Ring of Kerry and right down to Clonakilty and Killarney and everything. I've always wondered, do you think there's an Irish gentleman standing in Tipperary now singing It's a Long Way to Glasgow? Just wondered about that. So yes, Ireland, lovely. I've been right round the whole island. It's very, very beautiful. Why watch the news when the Scotty McClure show is about everyone knows everyone's business, says Sean Finlay. Absolutely, Sean. You don't need news if you're watching this. News should really just be a side show. But I think television has become very, very poor. A lot of repeats. Nothing really live. I suggested to a gentleman down south, he put me on his television station at night, and he went, "No, because you have a Scottish accent." So, that's just a piece of nonsense. It'd be brilliant. And everybody'd be attracted to go, "What's that Scottish guy talking about in our telly station?" I need to post you the link sometime if I can find it. You can't fling pieces out a 20-story flat. My lad loves that song, says Andy Thompson. Tremendous stuff. Very, very popular at the time. Whatever happened to Paladin? Glenn Michaels, wee pal. Paladin, yes. Palladio was the name of the great architect, wasn't it? A Palladian front. Scotty, that cold is sounding worse as you're going on. Bless, says Edward James. No, the cold's fine. Don't worry about it, Edward. Yes, Scotty, I remember telling you used to take him into work. Telling me you used to take, yes, Liam Thompson, yes. I used to take Lord Reith into work. He was known as the child by the lovable lassie. The lovable lassie would say, "Can I go and get the child?" And when he got fed up listening to me, he would put his big paws up at the window, and the lovable lassie would come through and take him in beside her. And then when he got fed up talking to her, he would put his big paws up at the window, and she would send him back into the studio, and he would lie beneath the desk. And when we fired the news jingle at night, Scott FM News, up would get Lord Reith and shake his collar. And a gentleman phoned me one night and he said, "Scotty, have you got a dog in the studio?" And I said, "Why do you ask?" He said, "Because I'm blind and I hear his collar medal rattle every evening. I hear it tinkle every evening." Yes, Scotty. Someone telling me, says Liam Thompson, "That's right. Do you think Sidney Devine should go on The Voice?" says Ian Walker. Well, that would be up to Sidney, but he'd certainly be fantastic in The Voice. Very popular man. For your man for the BBC, Scotty, I've just shared again. Oh, sorry, you're the man for the BBC, Scotty. I've just shared it again. I would have liked to have been the new controller of BBC Scotland, but it was an internal appointment. Sniffly Scotty, it's true you have a band of tissues named after your ailment. Yes, I do. A man-sized brand of tissues. So there you are. Help yourself to a Scotty. Still listening in Fortaventura. Go, Scotty. Three kisses, says Wendy Garrett. Fantastic. She's in Fortaventura. I think that's fabulous. Louis Fable says, yep, Aracher and Tarbet through Succoth. So there you are, says Louis. Louis is a very, very smart man, actually. I like his chat. There we are. My cousin from the RSA, and he had my cousin from RSA. I'm just reading this. He had slaves. They fled here because people were rioting and threatening to kill him. He landed in Glasgow penniless. They took his rand off him. He hitched a lift, Republic of South Africa, home to Motherwell, says Andrew. This is interesting. I'll just see if I can see more folks. Hitched a lift home to Motherwell. Now he's a very educated man. Fantastic. Yes, wonderful stuff. I think I'd put you in charge of Scottish space exploration and seaweed exports if we get independence, Scotty. What do you mean, if we get independence? Independence is coming, nothing surer. Hello, Scotty, from Shollands to the McClure Towers, says Mark Nicol. Fantastic, Mark. I'd love you to come and visit my croft in Old Shornmore, croft 159 in 2 years' time, to do a radio broadcast from the wooden music studio I've planned. It will face out to the Atlantic Ocean, says Vivian. Vivian Scott. How fantastic, Vivian. It sounds gorgeous. Andrew Thompson, 5 million, 2 weeks' wages for these rubbish footballers that just kick a ball about for 90 minutes and a kid on there injured. I know. Scotty McClure, is Scotty McClure not worth giving a bit of funding to, for goodness sake? If you think about it, what we've actually done here, hold on, there's somebody trying to, what are they trying to do? That's a very strange thing. Just bear with me, folks. I'll see if I can sort this for you. Doing something very, very weird. What does that mean? Does anybody know? Any of you out there? What does that actually mean? So there we are. We'll see if we can do that with it. Right. That's that. Yes, if you think about it, I provided you all with 36,000 hours of live broadcast unscripted over 25 years. I would have thought that's worth a fiver or a tenner. Do you know what I'm saying? Scotty, has anyone ever told you you have beautiful blue eyes? Says Edward James. No, Edward, nobody's ever told me. Thank you for that. Toto Vran Chitty, let me know what you're trying to do, Remedia. Let's see what we can put our heads together, see what I can come up with. With Toto Vran Chitty, you still have it big time, Toto Vran Chitty says. Fantastic, Toto Vran Chitty. I love it. Scotty, you will get it no problem. Dinky-doo, never mind her. She's a sandwich short of a toolbox, says Melissa McAleer. Andrew Thompson says, TV license, no chance paying that, and watch the same programme. You go on BBC iPlayer and you get nabbed, pardon me, for a TV license. Jim Clark's watching. Good show again, says Ron Stewart. I would hope so, Ron. I would hope we always deliver good value. I think women should get double what men get. They can work 2 days a week and my missus will be happy. I hope you feel better soon, Scottish Francis King. I'm choked up with the flu as well. Hopefully the weather gets better soon. Yes, just a wee bit nippy behind the eyes. But if you think about it, we used to do the programme when we had the flu, because you cannot leave the nation without their phoning. Nobody donates to the BBC. They're forced to pay under fear of being fined by a dark-coated man turning up outside the door with a signal and a searching device. I remember hearing this lady got a call from the licensing authority, and they said, we're doing an inspection. She said, that's absolutely fine. She said, I'll be out tomorrow when you come round, but what you can do is I'll put it behind the clock in the mantelpiece. And then apparently they turned up the next day. She was out. She forgot to tell her man. And her man opens the door and they said, BBC license detector van. And he said, well, we have got a license, but I couldn't tell you where it is. He said, it's behind the clock in the mantelpiece. She says, my goodness, that's some van you've got out there, I'll tell you. Right, so say hi to Cora, dinky-doo, Uncle Scotty, says Jim Clark. Dinky-doo to you, Jim. Oh, sounds a lovely old dog God bless the wee souls of Eddie Thompson and Angie. He was absolutely gorgeous. He was big. He wasn't fat. He was just huge. And you'll see pictures of him. I'll post, in fact, I'll post a picture. Lord Heath, one of the world's great images is me standing there on the left and Lord Heath with his paws up on the shoulders. Great show, Scotty. Hope the meetings go well in the week, says Steve Burrows. So do I, Steve, because it's getting crunch time now. Tarbet means crossing place, Viking speak. Well, there's Tarbet, which is at Loch Lomond, and there's Tarbert. You've got to make sure that you're doing the right speed when you go through Tarbet, because the village goes on for quite a long while there. It's a 30. It's Skype, says Vivian. Ah, is that what was making noise? Somebody was trying to Skype in. Melissa says, someone was calling you through Facebook. Ah, Facebook Messenger. Yes, wonderful. It's Domino's, says Ian Walker. Yes. Sounds like, so you have to throw a six, don't you? Double six there. Sounds like Facebook Messenger ringtone, that, Scotty, says Angie. Ah, somebody on the Messenger. It's the BBC trying to block your broadcast. Not at all. They wouldn't do that, Barry Wayne, for goodness sake. Trying to video call you, says Melissa McAleer. Marvellous stuff. Edward and Scotty need to get a room, says Martin Monaghan. Yes, it wouldn't actually suit us, Martin. I don't think we're on that bus. Louise Sullivan is watching. Barbara Ann Haig, you're a great institution, and I'm proud of all your accomplishments on the radio waves. Looking forward to seeing you getting some studio space and shake things up a bit. Absolutely, we'll go back to proper controversy and get stuff discussed. I can't believe I nearly missed you, says Louise Sullivan. No, never ever miss Scotty McClue. You miss a moment of Scotty McClue, you miss a moment of life, Louise Sullivan. Never do that. It sounded like a Facebook Messenger call, Captain, says George Raffin. Jim Thompson is watching. Scotty, you're a chicken nugget short of a happy meal. Lol. £10 on its way, Scotty, says Ron Stewart. Ron Stewart has very, very kindly agreed to stick £10 into Scotty McClue's GoFundMe page. Ron Stewart, you are a fabulous, fabulous man. Hi, buddy, says Big Jim. Scotty says, but I have to say, Rangers are not doing good. Can you give a shout out to Walter Smith? And please say we need him. Walter, great man. Nearly lights out, says Ian Walker. My goodness, so is Ian. You are quite right. Larbert, says Edward James. What's happening in Larbert, Edward? It's a while since I've been in Larbert. Oh, Tarbert. I think we were talking about Tarbert. There's Tarbert in Argyll. There's Tarbert in Harris. And there's Tarbet. So there you are. I saw Pabbie last night on the Isle of Harris. It was a beautiful island. Used to be home to 300 people. And now nobody stays there. Peter Parrott's watching Dinky Doo to you. Way to you, says Ron Stewart. Ron, that is wonderful. Thank you very much. Because obviously when you start something like that, everybody creates. They go, oh, he's looking for money. What would you fund him for? What would you fund Scotty McClure for, eh? Oh, no. It's because, if you think about it, have I given any of you any pleasure over the years? Have I given you a smile? I've always lived on applause or derision. There's no BBC licence fee funding me, and I would like us to start looking at purchasing media assets. So that's why we're raising the £5 million. So if you feel Scotty McClure, over the last 25 years, has given you a smile with 36,000 hours of live, unscripted broadcasting on radio and television, and, of course, on social media, then think, is he worth a fiver or a tenner? Good night, Scotty. Good night to all you lovely people. We'll chat to you all again next week. I'll spread the word for you, Scotty, says Francis King. Absolutely, Francis. Post this in millions of places. Night, Scotty. Hope you're feeling better soon, says Margaret Bonner. Good show, old man. You've done well considering there is Larbert as well. Well, Larbert, of course, is out in Stirlingshire. Am I not correct? Up between Stirling and Falkirk there. I'm no away to bind a war, Trump's favourite song. I'm no away, oh, I'm no away to build a war. Is that what he's singing? Old chap, I mean, says Edward James. Oh, my dear old chap. Thank you very much. Very, very kind of you. Thank you to all of you. Good night, mate, says Ron Stewart. Fantastic. It's time to go, isn't it? Yes, we are out of time. So, what we'll do We'll push off. Yes, there we are. I'll sing you the song, even though I've got a bit of a cold. Not to worry about that. Yes, excellent show again, Scotty. This is John Paul Preston. Heather Gauld Basmadjian says, "Good night, Scotty. Great show as always." She's out in America, I think. Is that right? Wireless boosters, any good, Scotty? I'm 10 pounding you after your show. It's only a raindrop, but every drip helps to build an ocean. Barry Wayne. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It's so much appreciated. Night night, Scotty. Thanks for the great show, says Vivian. What they're saying, my dad told me small rocks turn into big buildings, hence small donations make bigger things, says Andrew. Quite right. Shared for you, Scotty. She's in CA. So absolutely, says Heather Gauld and Basmagian. Karen Cox says, night, night, Scotty. Can't wait till next time. Great show tonight, mate. Dinky doo, Scotty, says the wonderful Ian Walker. That brings the show to a close. I say to all of you, thank you so much for your wonderful messages, for all your chit chat, for making this such a superb program. Share everything you possibly can. We'll upload it onto YouTube. This is Scotty McClue saying dinky doo to you. Have a fabulous week. Thanks very much for your company. Until next week at the same time, goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Take care, everybody, as you go. Goodbye, everybody. Auf Wiedersehen, au revoir, and a cheerio. Scotty McClure has left the building. Dinky-doo!